Good morning, students. Let's begin our social science class. Today, I am going to start new chapter in NCERT History, Nazism and the Rise of Hitler. Contents, introduction, story of Helmuth, birth of the Weimar Republic, the effects of the war, political radicalism and economic crisis. Introduction. This lesson explains the rise of Hitler and his art propaganda, the areas on which he concentrated to make Germany a world power. Background. In 1945, 11-year-old boy called Helmuth was lying in the bed. His father was discussing with his wife either to kill himself or all family members. Next day, in morning, his father took them all for a picnic and shot him dead. Helmuth came to know that his father was a Nazi and a supporter of Adolf Hitler, who wanted to make Germany a supreme power. Nazism is a structure of ideas about world politics whose leader was Adolf Hitler. Although Helmuth may not have realized all that it meant, his father had been a Nazi and a supporter of Adolf Hitler. Hitler's determination to make Germany into a mighty power and his ambition of conquering all of Europe. Let us see why Helmuth's father killed himself and what the basis of his fear was. In May 1945, Germany surrendered to the Allies, anticipating what was coming. Hitler, his propaganda minister Goebbels, and his entire family committed suicide collectively in his Berlin bunker in April. At the end of the war, an international military tribunal at Nuremberg was set up to prosecute Nazi war criminals for crimes against peace, for war crimes, and crimes against humanity. Germany's conduct during the war, especially those actions which came to be called crime against humanity, raised serious moral and ethical questions and invited worldwide condemnation. What were these acts? Under the shadow of the Second World War, Germany had waged a genocidal war, which resulted in the mass murder of selected groups of innocent civilians of Europe. The number of people killed included 6 million Jews, 2 lakh Gypsies, 1 million Polish civilians, 70,000 Germans who were considered mentally and physically disabled, beside innumerable political opponents. Nazi devised an unprecedented means of killing people, that is, by gassing them in various killing centers like Auschwitz. The Nuremberg Tribunal sentenced only 11 leading Nazis to death. Many others were imprisoned for life. The distribution did come get the punishment of the Nazi was far short of the brutality and extent of their crimes. The Allies did not want to be a harsh on defeated Germany as they had been after the First World War. Birth of the Weimar Republic. In the early years of the 20th century, Germany was a powerful empire. In 1914, Germany entered World War I against Allied power to occupy other country territories. Allied powers included England, France, and Russia, and later on, 1917, America also joined them. So, go through with the map where the location of England, France, and Russia. In the years of World War I, Germany made some gains by occupying France and Belgium. But in 1917, the US entry in World War I led to the defeat of Germany. The defeat came with the surrender of the German Emperor William II. Then parliamentary parties got an opportunity to redraft German's constitution. These parties met at the National Assembly in Weimar and established a democratic constitution. Parliamentary parties also set up the German parliament called Reichstag. This is the German parliament building, Reichstag. Members of the Reichstag were elected by all the adults, including the women. Then this government is in Germany was called the Weimar Republic. But soon this new Weimar Republic was not accepted well by its own people. Let us see why German people did not accept the Weimar Republic. The Weimar Republic signed the Treaty of Versailles and accepted the defeat of Germany in World War I. As per the treaty, Germany was forced to give some of its territories and minerals of iron and coal to France, Poland, Denmark, and Lithuania. Germany was also forced to pay £6 billion to Allied powers as compensation. Germany's military power was reduced and Allied powers took all its foreign colonies. Many Germans held the Weimar Republic responsible for humiliation at Versailles and called them November criminal. So all the things imposed by winner country to loser Germany termed as Versailles Treaty. The consequences of World War I. Now we are going to see effects of the war. The war had devastating impact on the entire continent, both psychologically and financially. Unfortunately, the infant Weimar Republic was being made to pay for the sins of old empire. The Republic carried the burden of war guilt and national humiliation and was financially crippled by being forced to pay compensation. Those who supported the Weimar Republic, mainly socialists, Catholics, and Democrats, became easy targets of attack in the conservative nationalist circle. The First World War left a deep imprint on European society and polity. It had a devastating impact on the entire continent, which is stated in the following points. Soldiers were ranked higher than civilians in society. Trench life of the soldiers was glorified by the media. But actually the things are different. Politicians and publicists laid greater stress on the need for men to be aggressive and masculine. Aggressive war propaganda and national honor occupied center stage in the public sphere. People's support grew for the recently established dictatorship. Democracy as a young and fragile idea could not survive in the instabilities of the interwar Europe. Now the topic: political radicalism and economic crisis. After World War I, the political conditions of Europe changed completely. The support for dictatorship grew and support for democracy decreased. Since Germany lost the war and the Weimar Republic had to sign the Treaty of Versailles, people lost faith in this democratically formed government. People hated the Weimar Republic government for taking poor economic decisions. That is why people demanded dictatorship. Many revolutionary groups were formed which were demanding different styles of government in Germany. There was a revolution of the Spartakist League on the pattern of the Bolshevik Revolution in Russia. Spartakists were the people who wanted Germany to be run by the working class people. Soviets of workers were established in many cities. The Weimar Republic crushed all these uprisings. In Berlin also, political developments demanded the Soviet style of governance. Spartakists later founded the Communist Party of Germany. Communists and socialists both were against each other, and there was no common opposition to Hitler. Later, Germany started suffering from an economic crisis. Now, what is economic crisis? Germany took loans to fight the war and had to repay in gold. Gold reserves started getting depleted, so Germany refused to pay the loan. To cover the loan from Germany, France occupied its major industrial area, Ruhr. On the other side, Germany started printing more currency. The currency of Germany was mark. Since Germany was only printing currency and no production was going on, the value of German currency fell and inflation increased. Prices of goods became extraordinarily high, which led to hyperinflation in Germany. In those situations, the United States of America intervened and helped Germany to get out of these crises. He introduced a plan through which German can recovery in economy, and this plan known as Dwas plan. So Dwas plan was introduced for making Germany's loan repayment easier. So that's all for today. Thank you very much. Have a nice day.